Coming to you live from my apartment, it's Rob Has a Podcast, and now here's the guy who's more excited to be talking about Big Brother than if I won the best beard contest at the county fair, Rob Cesternino. Hello, everybody, and welcome officially to our coverage of Big Brother 16 here on Rob Has a Podcast. We are back. It's the most twisted podcast ever, and with me, as always, here he is, Mr. Brian Lynch. Brian, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, Rob. Hello, everyone. Hope you're all well.
Hope everybody is doing well. I just want to take a moment at the top of the show tonight. I know we're going to have a lot of fun talking about the Big Brother premiere, but I just want to take a second just to say on a very sad note, we found out late last night about the passing of one of the members of the Survivor family, Caleb Bankston, who was the fiance of Colton from Survivor. Was killed in an accident, and if you're just hearing that news for the first time, I'm sorry to have to report that, but it's been a big news story today, and he's somebody who I didn't know particularly well, but all of the survivors that knew him said he was a really great guy. So just want to send our thoughts and prayers out to all the members of the community of fans around the show are all very, very upset about this, and sending thoughts and prayers to Caleb and Colton's families. It's very tough stuff to have to deal with. So sorry, a little bit of a down note to kick things off, but I felt like we needed to say send our thoughts.
I agree. I'm heartbroken over it as well.
I know. Nicole's very upset too. It's a terrible story. He was killed worked on a railway, and he was killed in an accident. It was just a terrible story. Very, very upsetting. We're here to talk about Big Brother tonight. It was the first part of a two-part Big Brother premiere, and Brian, very exciting to have Big Brother back.
Yeah, but I kind of feel like this experience was split in half.
Yeah,
like I didn't get to the completion of it.
Yeah, so we'll talk about this. I wasn't crazy about how it all played out tonight. I feel like it was sort of an incomplete experience. I feel like I would have loved to have seen all 16 people that we got to know in our preview. I would have liked to have seen them all in the house on night number one. I feel like we should have gotten to find out more about what the twists are, and I feel like we don't really know much more than we knew going into tonight's episode. Do you feel like we learned anything new about how the game is going to be played out this summer?
Well, we learned about Team America, that there will be like two more votes for to set up a three-person Team America alliance that you control, just like America's Player. It'll just be three players this season.
Okay. All right, so we know a little bit more about Team America, and that's about it. We still don't know exactly the mechanics of the second HOH and how that the Battle of the Block and how that's going to play out.
No, we don't, but we'll find out tomorrow.
Okay. All right, so and on the plus side, we got to really know these eight players. Hopefully we get to similarly know the eight players tomorrow. Also, I think I was more interested in seeing some of the people that are coming into the house tomorrow. So some of my early favorites from this season are the people that aren't in the house yet. So it wasn't the eight people that I would have picked to spend the most time with, but we did get a lot of fun moments in the house, and we'll go through everything tonight as we recap Big Brother 16 and take your questions. Of course, just to start things off, if you're just joining us for the first time, we do our live shows. We're going to be live this season right now, especially in the early going. We're planning on being live Wednesday, Thursday, and Sunday. So all three nights of Big Brother, especially when there's so many people in the house, we are going to be live after each episode of the season. Tonight, Brian and I are going to get you started. Tomorrow night, Ian Terry will be with us. He'll be with us most eviction nights, and then on Sunday nights. And on Wednesday, we'll try to get Big Brother alumni to join us or other Big Brother guests to talk about everything with you guys as we go along here all season long. We're going to do our shows live. They're on our YouTube channel. You can go to robhasawebsite.com/YouTube to subscribe. And we'll also have a podcast version of this available on robhasawebsite.com. You could subscribe to our main podcast, which is all of the shows we cover at robhasawebsite.com/iTunes. Or for just Big Brother, you can go to robhasawebsite.com/BBpodcast. That will take you to our iTunes feed of the Big Brother podcast. Okay, and of course, you can always tweet us during our live shows with the hashtag RHAP. Brian, Tomorrow is the last day to get your early bird special on the Big Brother live feeds. I think tomorrow afternoon you have to pay full price, no more 20% off.
Right, so if you're going to get the feeds, go ahead and get them.
Yeah, this is the last night to get the 20% off early bird special. Of course, when you buy your live feeds through robhasawebsite.com, we are sending you a ticket to play Big Brother Bingo, a bingo card to win 500 potentially. Go to robhasawebsite.com/bingo to find out all the information and how to get your bingo card. I've been sending the bingo cards all week, a whole assembly line going on over here. I'll tell you what, if you also, if you get, buy your bingo card in the next couple days and you know the feeds come on, you can't wait, I will email you a copy of your bingo card. If you're nervous you're gonna miss something, I will get it in the mail as soon as possible. But I can also email it to you. You can email me rob@robhasawebsite.com after you pick up your feeds, and I'll get that over to you. Okay, Brian, let's get into talking about the episode here. Okay, let's start off just sort of the big picture. We had 8 people go into the house tonight. It was Paola, Donnie, Cody, Frankie, Amber, Nicole, Devin, and Joey. Who made the best impression on you tonight?
You know, I'm going to have to say I was fairly impressed with Paola. I thought she was going to kind of blow up her chances early, just as soon as she walked through the door. But I think what Devin was able to do, I mean, being the bigger guy, he's probably going to be a target. So, I mean, the people on his team are going to want to keep him to fight against the other teams. So I think that he's made inroads trying to strengthen that alliance. So I'm impressed with what he's done.
Brian, but you know how I feel about this, that, you know, I feel like there were so many Big Brother sins that were committed here in this first episode. Number one, how many times do we see in Big Brother history, both in the U.S. and in Canada, and most recently, if you didn't watch Big Brother Canada, there was a whole thing of there was a first five alliance of the first five people in the house. They had an alliance, and spoiler, it did not work out to be the final five people in the house. We always see in Big Brother where it's like, hey, we're the first six people in the house, and those other people are outside, so let's all make an alliance, and it never works. These people seem very excited about this, that they're going to stick to the eight. We have the crazy eights, then we had El Cuatro, we have Double D. Is it too many alliances on the first 3 hours of being in the house?
Maybe when it comes to El Cuatro or Double D, you know, I mean, the whole big alliance, that whole group thing was a good idea, right? Go ahead and get that group together. Or at least you want to be in that group, right? You might not want to be the person that goes out there and says, put it together, but you want to be in that group.
Yeah, you want to be in the group. Ideally, you want to be in the group of eight, but I get the sense that there are people who are in that group of eight who feel like, hey, this is the eight. We're gonna be the final eight. And Big Brother history tells us there is a 0.0% chance of that happening, of these people sticking together. Forget the whole summer, pass into July, where that there is no chance this group of eight is sticking together.
Yeah, that's the thing with Devin. He doesn't really have much of a chance. If he can get to jury, I mean, he's done a great job, right?
Yeah, Devin, you know, I know you said that you were impressed with him, and I think Devin seems like a nice guy, but way, way, way overplaying the game early on. I mean, he's the one pushing for the alliance of eight. He's the one pushing with Donnie, hey, we need to have the Double D's alliance. It's just way too much on night one.
I think what impressed me about him was when he got Donnie to admit to him that he was a huge fan of the show.
Yeah.
And that's when he wanted to do that alliance with him.
Well, I will say I think that Donnie was probably the guy that impressed me the most on night one. I feel like Donnie is a real sleeper, and that was probably a bad thing to talk about how big of a fan he was of the show. I think he might be a little overly excited, but I think that Donnie was impressive on night one.
Yeah, but what I'm saying about Devin is that he has that information on Donnie now. He has leverage over Donnie because Donnie told him that. So maybe there is a way for them to both work forward positively and get each of them, you know, further in the game.
Let's talk through our eight people that we saw come into the house. Just real quick, just go through our first impressions. Brian, is it hard when you are a Big Brother contestant to have to pretend that you are excited about getting a key when there is obviously a camera crew following you around?
How would I know, obviously, but no, it wouldn't be hard to be excited when someone's giving a freaking key to the Big Brother house. You're going to be ecstatic.
Yeah.
But who's faking that?
I just find it a little patronizing. I feel like, I know this is fake. You know this is fake. We're just going through the motions that we all know you're going to the Big Brother house. Maybe I'm just being cranky.
I don't know. I mean, it's like the setup.
You still get excited.
I do get excited about it. Even like the cheesy stuff. I'm a fan of cheesy if it's kind of classy cheese.
Okay, let's go through our eight people that we met in the order we met them. Paola, she was a thick skin. She is willing to manipulate the hot guys and even the ugly guys. She has a lot of eyelashes that she's going to bring into the house. What do you think of Paola? She seems like she is single and ready to mingle.
Yeah, she was kind of all over Cody, right? She wants to lick him. She was talking about wanting to lick his body in front of everybody during the HOH comp.
Yeah.
Now, what's that about? Does that not put a target on you?
Potentially. I mean, somebody needs to get out the hose and really just hose Paola down because it's too much, and she really gets all horned up talking about Cody. And there could be some sort of a rivalry between Frankie and Paola over who is going to get with Cody.
Yeah, because Frankie kind of and then Cody let Frankie rub on his abs too, which I thought was very nice of Cody to do.
Yeah. Brian, did you like all of the crunching going on tonight's episode?
Yeah, I liked how Frankie wore their asses out. They thought they was going to put their abs up against Frankie's, and he just destroyed them. That was great.
All right, let's talk a little bit more about Donnie. That his claim to fame, obviously, was Kelly Pickler's janitor. I thought he had a strong first night in the house. We see that he gets the Dodo music a lot in the house, but he has like a lot of folksy things that he ends up saying in the diary room. His parents tell him, don't take any wooden nickels. What's your take on hashtag BB Donnie?
I don't like that he gets the Dodo bird music. I mean, he is one of the two more informed game knowledge people in the house at this moment, right? So, I mean, it's kind of him and Nicole are the two I would consider the smarter game knowledge people. So I think he's probably got a very good head on his shoulders about what's going to happen in the house.
All right, Cody as well. We saw him. He's also single and ready to mingle. So he's the former soccer player and the guy that Paola and Frankie are drooling over. But I have to say, I thought he had a pretty good night in night one for Cody.
Yeah, there was that moment when Pow Pow was trying to like suck him in a little bit.
Whoa. How do you, Brian, family podcast.
Well, not so. Stuck him into the bed, right? She wanted to be in the bed with them, right?
Yes.
I don't know what's going to happen with them. Are they going to get together? Is she going to get, when these other people come to the house, there could be a whole another round of jealous fights. We already see some brewing, right?
I think so. What's your read on Cody? Do you think that he likes Paola?
He didn't move closer to her in that bed when they were talking and she was flirting with him, right?
Did I forget what he said? Did he say that he thought that Paola was attractive? Paola has a crush on him. I don't know if they said who Cody had a thing for.
Cody is interested in Paola. During the introductions, he said that he was interested in her.
Okay. All right. We'll see where that goes. Then we have Frankie Grande. Brian, it's happening. The Frankie Grande era is here.
That's correct. I mean, he was worried about Paola knowing who he was being from New York. It seems like he dodged that bullet.
Now, Brian, did you know this about Frankie Grande that we found out tonight? So he actually has a sister who is a very famous recording artist. Did you know this about Frankie Grande?
Before tonight, yeah, because we did the preview podcast and talked about it, but I didn't know before then.
Is this confirmed? Is Frankie Grande actually the brother of Ariana Grande? I thought he implied it, but I wasn't sure if I didn't catch it. Was that officially? Do we know this for sure?
Do we know it for sure? Well, I mean,
he was very subtle about it. He didn't make it abundantly clear. He didn't give me enough evidence yet to show that he is actually the brother. So we allegedly the brother of recording artist Ariana Grande. I'm not sure. He's being a little coy about it.
Well, Big Brother has to be lying, right? They put her on a phone call, so it would have to be not really her. Plus, they played one of her songs,
yeah.
So they would have to go out of their way to pay somebody for that, which they're not going to do.
Yeah. Only 17 Ariana Grande references in the Big Brother premiere. Frankie is the first HOH. Did you like that, him winning HOH number one off the bat, Brian?
I mean, it's a risk-reward kind of situation, you know? I mean, could he have been the target for the other team coming in? Possibly, yeah, right? Yeah. If they think that there's some kind of... Especially if there's someone that knows who Ariana Grande is, right?
Yeah, I think so. Now, is that going to make him a target, you know, that he is... Like, he seemed concerned that Paola, oh, she's a DJ, she's going to know who my sister is, and if she knows who my sister is, then I'll get voted out. Do you think that that is a legit reason why he would get voted out of the house?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, because there could be some kind of... public vote down the line.
I guess so.
Everyone could lose other than him. I mean, honestly, if there's somebody that's going to get a billion votes, you want to kick them out. But you kind of, unless you can, like, harness the power of that whatever, you know.
What if they were to weaponize Frankie Grande? Is that a legit strategy? Would that work to weaponize him?
I don't think it can't work now because they've got this Team America thing, which, okay, so we don't know who the first person voted Team America was, right?
I think
we all know who the first person was. So we need to talk about who we want second in that team of three, in that alliance of three.
Okay, so we know that Frankie Grande is going to be that. So these three
people...
It's
not confirmed, but we kind of know, right?
It's pretty confirmed.
Yeah.
So... So Frankie Grande will be one. Who would we want to have? Obviously, it's going to be somebody from night one, right?
No. Not one.
Why?
Has nothing to do with it because this vote. Well, I mean,
is it cumulative or is it, I mean, how could somebody who wasn't even in the house get the votes?
Okay, so the first vote happened before we even finished our first podcast, our preview podcast. So
got
that vote
it.
Was over with. That's why we couldn't find it when we was looking for it. So I don't know when are they going to release this next vote or whatever. I don't think it's necessarily it has to be somebody that first came into the house. If it's something that's released online, it's not going to be people that are watching the show that gets involved with that vote, I don't believe.
Okay. So Frankie Grande, do you think that he will come out of this okay as the first HOH?
Yeah, it depends. It depends. I mean, being HOH does not matter for the other side. Like, if the other side wins this battle of the block, which Julie did not inform the house guests about, right?
Yeah. This is an interesting question from that I have on my Twitter feed, Brian. Brandon Neuenheis is asking me, if Frankie gets a room with pictures and he is the brother of Ariana Grande, will there be pictures of them together? Could there be a letter even from Ariana Grande?
I mean, yeah, don't you... Is this going to come out?
They're best friends.
Unless they do that thing where it's too early to get it, right? Sometimes they do that.
Yeah, I mean, I guess does she have to use her last name? Like is Grande his actual last name? I know that... What do you think about this?
I don't know. Well, God forbid she uses her initials and they think it's Allison Grodner.
Oh, it could be Allison Grodner sending a note. Oh, my God. Yeah, so I guess that they could probably just say his last name is, you know, Frankie Thompson.
I think what you do is just get a letter from whoever else in the family and just leave her out of it, right?
Sure.
Unless
all right.
his secret's exposed.
All right, let's just go through other people. Amber, I thought her, we really didn't get to see much from her in her package. I, like, looked the other way for a second, and I missed her package entirely, right? They just showed her, like, hey, she's climbing rocks, and, like, they just moved on to the next person, right?
Yeah, and she said she likes shooting guns, and she's very confident. I did love how she threw that competition, though.
Yeah? You were impressed with Amber so far?
Yeah, well, I mean, she just hopped right on off, and it really did look like she threw it, so I'm not really concerned about her lying about that in the DR, but no one questioned it, so I appreciate that from her.
What do you think of the really Amber Paola and to a lesser degree Joey are really pushing the Women's Alliance, El Cuatro? Do you think that this is a good thing to be pushing for so hard?
I'm kind of concerned about what's going to happen when the other girls come into the house. It is kind of odd to hear a girls' alliance called El Cuatro. I almost want to call it La Cuatro.
Yeah, you want to feminize the word Cuatro?
Or El. El is a masculine term, right?
Okay. Brian, you're more fluent in Espanol than I am.
That's all I know about Espanol.
is Cuatros. Yeah. And we know that from Big Brother Canada that having an alliance named Cuatro is not necessarily the best way to go.
Yeah, I don't think it's spelled with a Q, though, is it?
Why? How would they in Spanish?
Is it C? I don't even know how to spell it.
I don't know. We'd have to get that confirmed. So Amber, and again, not much to her package. Then Nicole, we get like a little bit of a different side to her. We knew she was from a small town, but we actually got to see her riding tractors and cornholing. How about, did you realize that Nicole was so good at cornholing?
I did not, but I kind of smiled when she said that her mom and dad told her not to be lying, but she kind of smiled at the camera and said, but she's going to have to, so she's ready to disappoint them.
Yeah, Nicole is really, she's pretty adorkable, and she is she's very quirky so far. She gets scared, and she's going to need to sleep butt to butt with somebody in the bed. Which is fine. I'm sure that some of the guys in the house would not mind volunteering for that. However, she has another problem, though, where sometimes she wets her pants.
Well, I mean, we've seen that people, like, sometimes wet their pants when they laugh. Is that what she was talking about?
I'm not sure. Have we seen that before in the Big Brother house? Have we seen anybody wet their pants on the live feeds yet?
In Big Brother Canada, yes.
Yeah. Why, who wet their pants on Big Brother Canada?
I think Netta was wet. Yeah, Netta peed her pants when she was laughing too hard.
Oh, my God. That should have been a square on Live Feed Bingo. All right, well, for 2015, we'll get that. Somebody remind me a year from now to get house guests pees their pants. We've seen house guests pee in the hot tub, but not in their pants. So that could be a potential issue for anybody who shares the bed with Nicole. I was like, easy on the champagne, Nicole. Be careful.
She seemed like she didn't run around. She's quiet, right? Like she seemed to get more quiet, didn't she?
Yeah. Okay, I'm just worried about her.
It's good to be. It would be better to be quieter in the house, right?
Yeah, but I'm worried about her peeing her pants the first night.
I'm not worried about that. Even if she did, she just cleaned it up.
People don't need a reason to put you on the block in week one. I could see the HOH saying, Nicole, you and I really didn't get to know each other this first week, and you kind of peed your pants the first night, and,
I was in the bed with you. It got all over me.
we were butt to butt, and, look. If peeing your pants was cool, I'd be Miles Davis. All right, so let's talk about Devin, who also had a big night. What do you think, Brian? Would you rather Devin or The Rock? Who looks better?
I'll have to go with The Rock. I like tattoos.
Okay. I might say Devin. I feel like The Rock is getting a little weird looking.
Devin's gonna, if he can stick around, he's gonna be very interesting. I mean, he said he's like not looking to jump into the sack right away, but it's definitely going to happen.
Well, okay, a couple things here on Devin. A couple things that are just not adding up to me. So Devin is a single full-time dad. Can you help me make sense of that? What is a single full-time dad?
It's a guy that raises his child by himself all the time.
But full-time dad implies that you don't have a job and you're the, you know, you are the, like, if I'm a, you know, a full-time mom or a full-time dad, that I feel like that implies that your spouse is the breadwinner earning an income. But how could you be a single full-time dad unless you are like, does he like live with his parents and they take care of the kid or they just let him live there for free?
Plus, let's be honest, there's nothing full-time about his dadship going on for the next 3 months, right? If he's going to win this.
Yeah, so I don't know. But maybe somebody could help me explain that. Okay, so here's my thing that I am the most confused about Devin. Okay, so here we go. We have everybody introducing themselves, and, you know, those Big Brother introductions, like, it's basically, it's hard to miss on that. It's like, you know, short of saying, like, hey, I'm a serial killer, everybody, no matter what you say, be like, whoa! It's a hot room. Everybody, it's an easy crowd to please, right, Brian?
Well, sometimes, you know, but I mean, sometimes there's people staring at you critically. Yeah, it's easy to please them where they're going to clap and applaud you to your face, but they'll just go right into the diary room, talk trash about you behind your back. Yeah. Who was it that Devin, like, it was Amber that was like, had, oh my God, Devin is so hot. And then
yes.
They went to Devin, and Devin was like, oh my God, Joey is so hot. And then it showed Amber looking all pissed off at Joey. That was great.
I know. It was so crazy. Like, you go to Amber, she's like, oh, that's my tall, dark, and handsome. Devin is so hot. And then we go to Devin in the diary room, and I'm expecting him to say, oh man, Amber is so my type. And instead he says, oh, Joey, oh, she's a 10, so hot. Brian, that I thought they went to HD in the house this year. I felt, was there a problem with my transmission? What is Devin seeing that I'm missing?
I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's hair color. Maybe
is
like
that it? He's
blue hair.
He's into the blue heads. Is that what it is?
Blue nets.
Is it possible that this is where Devin's baseball career went awry, that he actually needs LASIK eye surgery, and that's where he's getting that Joey is a 10 out of 10?
I don't know. Are you saying Joey's not a 10 out of 10?
I'm saying that Joey is not a 10 out of 10. Although Scott St. Pierre is direct messaging me that Joey is totally hot. So maybe I'm just not into the blue heads.
Well, maybe. I mean, what are you saying? Like, is her body? I think she's. It may be a short haired thing, right? You might not be attracted to short haired women.
I don't love the short hair, but there's definitely women that I've seen with short hair who I think are more attractive than. I don't want to get into, you know, that she's unattractive. I just felt like that. Go 10 out of 10 for Joey. This is.
Is there a possibility that she could be dressing down as well too? You know,
I
mean, wearing clothes that maybe look bigger on her. I mean, this could be like a total game thing that we, as guys, never even think about.
Okay, I think I would have ranked her 4 out of 4 if between the four the members of El Cuatro at this point.
I would have to say, like, strategically in this game, I feel better about her chances than I did when we were talking about her during the preview.
Yeah, although I still don't like the fact that she is so. You know, politically focused.
Yeah, she talked about that in her intro, but she didn't really bring that out into the house. So as long as they don't do that, we're all right. I mean, like Helen last year, she never, ever really talked politics. Unless someone really pressed her about wanting to know about it personally to get to know her, she would talk about it a little bit, but she always kept, you know, her politics out of the game.
Yeah, Joey's looking for some hot liberal men in the house.
She might be able to find her one.
Okay. Not tomorrow night when Caleb, right?
Yeah.
Not the liberal. Yes. Okay. So we have a bunch of alliances that are forming, after night one. A lot of showmances. Brian, is this the most potential showmancing going on after one night in the Big Brother house?
Well, if you like break it down to like there only being eight people in the house, I would say, yeah, but you got to qualify by what showmancing actually is at this point, right?
Seems like people are definitely ready for some relationships. Like, you know, just a lot of alliances and a lot of potential pairs. So Paola is so into Cody. Did you think that were you getting shades of Gina Marie and Nick between Paola and Cody?
Gosh, no. But actually, see, I don't really know because I don't have feeds, right? I don't see how they've been interacting. So maybe if I just think about like what I saw from season 15 on the show, then maybe, yeah, I would consider about the same.
You can't see Paola potentially walking around with Cody's hat for weeks on end after he gets evicted next week?
Oh, yeah. Well, I could see that, but I don't think that – I mean, do you think that Cody – I mean, well, yeah, he's in danger as a physical – threat. I mean, it's possible that he'll get targeted and taken out first.
No, I think Cody's going to be fine. I think that, you know, he definitely gave me more of a Hayden vibe, which is basically like sort of like the, you know, the young athletic guy who isn't like really pushing too hard. And, you know, Nick Juhas was sort of like came right in and was like, hey, guys, we're going to make Moving Company right now. We're going to get an alliance of five people. And so, you know, he was sort of like, that's not Cody.
I think he don't last long if he gets sucked into this showmance.
Yeah.
It's because he'll be targeted.
All right, so we're going to start to get more and more into taking your comments. Here's one about the subject we're discussing. This is from Unsuccess Story, a.k.a. Michael J. I fear young Cody is in danger of being Juhas. No, I don't – well, again, how do we mean danger of getting Juhas? Are we worried that Paola is going to, you know, stalk him and take his stuff and pine for him all season, or that he's in danger of being the second boot and potentially getting burned by the America voting twist?
I think it's knowing that there are people coming to the house, associating with someone in a way to make it look like you're a showmance, when they're going to have an opportunity to, I mean, they've got to figure it out that there's teams, right? And that these people are going to nominate them. So yeah. Who's the most likely people to nominate? People that you know are going to be working together.
Well, what do we think? Do we think that, okay, so these eight people that are already in the house, do you think they're going to be one team and they're going to be competing against the other team? Do you think that we'll have a second HOH competition tomorrow night, or do you think there'll be some sort of like, okay, decide who the HOH is?
Yes.
It'll be...
there'll be another HOH competition. There'll be another HOH competition.
And so after the second HOH competition, then will we have nominees by tomorrow night?
Maybe. Yeah, and then the next one would be the Battle of the Block, and then a veto comp, and then the eviction.
Do you think that there will be a veto and Battle of the Block, or will the Battle of the Block replace the veto?
No, they're not going to replace... No. Even in media days, they built the puzzle they used was a veto thing. They're not going to get rid of the veto.
Okay. I'm just checking.
They're going to get rid of... what they'll get rid of is the... if they're going to get rid of competitions, unless they're going to cram them in, they're going to get rid of the have-not competitions.
Get rid of the have-not competition. I hate the have-nots.
It's not getting rid of them, though. It's just like eliminating them up to a certain extent until we eliminate this twist, which is what we do.
That's fine. Okay, so Bobby Kelly in the chat room says nominees are Sunday. So then the two HOHs, do we have a sense of how they will come up with the nominees? Like, will they nominate people like Frankie? Will he have to nominate two people from his own group of eight, or can he nominate two people from the entire house? Because if the HOHs are vulnerable, I feel like it has to be either he can nominate anybody in the house, or he has to nominate two people from the other team.
I would feel like he would have to nominate two people from the other team. Like, during the cliques, we played with teams, right? Four teams.
Yes.
And they couldn't nominate people from their own team. Therefore, it gave you the option. It was what I considered Big Jeff's best move. It was like when he first came in, he went to everybody else. He went to the popular kids and like became and good with them. So if they won, they would never come after him. The people that wanted him out was the athletes, the team he was on that couldn't go after him at all. So, I mean, we'll probably see some of that, but if it's you can nominate your own people, I mean, okay. This is like no holds barred at that point.
Well, it would make sense, though, if you have to nominate two people from the other side of the house, because that way then you have the battle of the block, and then whatever group wins the battle of the block, then their people come off, and then only the two nominations are left from the other side of the house.
But I imagine that they could do it either way, right? That you could do it like where you can nominate your own people, or that would be not allowed. So it's just unclear at this point.
Okay. All right, so let's go ahead. Or maybe would it be the two pairs of people? Like when it's the battle of the block, instead of like, I'm thinking it's like a Survivor and we'll have like a tribe. The one side of the house competes against the other side of the house. It's probably going to be the two people who are on the block like have to work together against the other two people that are on the block. I think that's interesting.
Like that would be.
Two versus two.
Yeah. Would I mean, the HOH get in? Would the HOHs get in on it?
No. It's just the two people on the two nominees versus two nominees. Tag team championship, Ryan.
I'm down with that.
Okay,
I like that.
Okay. Let's talk about a couple other things from the show tonight. We talked a little bit about the sit-up contest. Was that weird? A bunch of guys doing crunches on night one?
Well, I mean, I've talked about, like, how working out is not good, right? But they had this camaraderie thing going on. Frankie brought everybody back together at one point and said, hey, I've got to have my back with this thing, right, being the first HOH. So the narrative in the house is that this group is going to work together as a cohesive alliance. We have subplots, you know, the Double D Alliance, the El Cuatro Alliance. So, I mean, where it goes from here, it truly depends on what happens when the second group comes in.
Okay.
What's the first cross-team alliance? That's going to be interesting as well.
That's going to be very interesting. Anything from the HOH competition tonight? Were you impressed with this particular HOH competition?
I mean, we've seen it before, like the bull in the china shop thing where like you fall off the log, and they call it go fly kite, but this really is like stay on the rolling log until you fall off. So, I mean, it's just kind of a rehashed comp, but it's an endurance comp that goes kind of quickly, I guess. So,
yeah. I didn't think it was the most exciting HOH challenge on night one that we've ever seen.
No, but I mean, it served its function, I guess.
Is Big Brother trying to force too hard the, hey, it's summer, Big Brother? Like, I watched an interview with Julie Chen the other day where that it's the preview of the season that's on CBS.com, and they start off, it's like, burr, 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 and Julie Chen says, well, you know, so, Big Brother and summer have become synonymous. Like, like they're really trying to force that. Like the background of everything is a pool. It's a beach party. Everybody's in bikinis. It's really like they're just trying to really, really drive it home. Big Brother is about summertime fun, Brian.
That's subliminal advertising. That's like, instead of you going to the beach, we show you the beach so you'll feel like sitting at home and watching our show.
Yeah. Instead of being out in the summertime fun, how about you stay inside all summer and watch people outside? How about that?
Yes, sit on your couch and watch our live feeds 24/7.
If anything, Big Brother should be on in the winter. And it's like, hey, it's cold outside, but you can watch people outside in the sun having fun because it's too cold to go outside. That would be much better.
That's what the Canadians do.
Okay. So, yes, and they have an indoor pool. Okay. One thing from tonight's HOH competition, when Joey blurts out, come on, Amber, you got this. Like, or anybody. Anybody's got this.
Oh, that was funny. It was a pow-pow, though, like talking about wanting to lick all over Cody, though, during that. That was just cracked me up.
Yes. Boy, pow-pow is, she's ready for, it's going to be a long summer for pow-pow if she doesn't find a buddy soon.
Yeah, she just got worked up about the sunscreen getting splashed all over him, so he looked like a lollipop, wanted to lick him up and down. Everybody's like, what?
Oh boy. Okay. So, Frankie Grande says, "Go Grande or go home." Brian, how often do you go Grande?
Only when I don't go Venti.
Okay. There you go. All right. And so Frankie comes into the house and sits in the orange chair, but finds out that there will be a second HOH, and we sort of get a little bit about the twist. Eight people on their way into the house tomorrow night. Who are you most excited to see tomorrow?
Obviously, I'm most excited to see Zach. Like, during those clips, the only thing that really stuck with me was, like, when Zach came on for those sneak peeks and said, "I'm going to lie every single time I open my mouth."
Brian, how could you say that? We found out the revelation that Christine is a nudist, which was somehow we missed in her bios in the preview show.
I didn't realize Christine was a nudist.
Yeah, Christine is sitting there like reading the newspaper, being completely naked. "I love being naked," she said.
You're dropping unexpected stuff on me at this point, man. I don't know what to say.
Do we think that Christine will go naked on the live feeds?
Is she the female Arlie?
Well, we said Zach was the American Arlie. We could be seeing some naked Christine on the live feeds, Brian.
I don't believe we will.
You don't think so? She's a nudist.
Well, I mean, she didn't seem, okay, from what she said in her interview, she didn't seem like the type of person that would be overly thrilled to start walking around naked in the Big Brother house, but I could be completely wrong.
I don't think she sees it as a sexual thing. I think she just likes being naked.
Well, I don't see it as a sexual thing either. I'm just saying, I mean, do you just walk around? I mean, I don't know. Maybe she does, maybe she doesn't. I don't know what to say.
All right, well,
I'll report it if she starts flashing the nipples around.
Yeah, Brian Lynch will report when Joey poops and when Christine is naked on the Big Brother live feeds. Last night to get the early bird special on the Big Brother live feeds. Anything else you want to hit on from the episode, much like Paola hitting on Cody, before we get to the questions from our very excited live audience tonight?
No, I think we went through it pretty well, actually.
Okay. All right. So let's jump into taking some of these questions live from our audience here. Let's start it off here with Brock Cheek, who says, "Who from tonight's eight are you hoping we see all summer, and who are you hoping goes early?" All right, Brian, let's have you can protect one person, and one person is going home this week. Give me your pick from the tonight's first eight.
If I want to protect somebody, I would want to protect somebody like, oh my gosh, like Devin, possibly. Somebody that is in danger of going home that has the capabilities of really tearing the house up.
Yeah.
Send somebody home?
Yeah, who's going home? Send somebody home, Brian. You're Dan Gieseling right now. It's the first episode, and you're the coach, and you got somebody. You're sending somebody packing right now. Who is it?
I get rid of Paola.
Pow.
Yep.
Pow.
She seemed like she had too much control when she started getting the girls together, and that's just not good for anyone's game in the house, is it?
No, I might keep her around. I think I'm going by who's going to bring us the most entertainment this summer, and I feel like the person that I think is going to bring us the least, Amber, I'm sorry, get to stepping. You're out. I'd send Amber home, and I think the person, Frankie Grande, I don't think he needs my protection. Paola, I may keep her around. I think Nicole is going to be fun. Devin's going to be fun. How about Donnie? I think Donnie needs some protection here in the first couple of weeks. But if he makes it for a little bit, I think he's good. Okay.
Heck, Donnie's got all the protection he needs. He's already got that meat shield, Devin. Right up next to him.
You love the meat shield. Okay. Yeah. Let's take a one from at NYItalian27, Michelle wants to know, do you think it was okay for Julie to announce that there were super fans in the eight house guests before they entered? What do you think, Brian? Was that okay to identify that there were super fans in the group?
Yeah, just to cause drama. I mean, something like that does cause drama.
Yeah,
people
I don't think
to figure out who the super fan is. I mean, she didn't call anybody out, so I mean, no, I don't think there's anything wrong with that at all.
Yeah, stuff like that typically would bother me. That was not something that really bothered me at all. It wasn't like, you know, there's one person who's the obsessed fan and everybody else is, you know, Donnie and Nicole both are the super fans. The other people, I don't think they care too much. So not a big deal. Okay. Riot Maker, the troublemaker, says, do you think that four noms are battle of the block and the winner is safe? They pick one of the HOHs to take their spot on the block. Boy, that's kind of crazy. Do you think that it's possible that the HOHs could then have to switch with somebody? I think that's a little getting a little tricky.
The only thing that I thought was when Julie asked Frankie to sit in the nomination chairs, as in, it just made me think, well, maybe the HOHs will be the one that battles for control of the block, right? So, I mean, I really don't know what's going to happen. They could do just about anything.
I just think that let's say Frankie is the HOH of one side of the house. Like, I feel like that the other HOH could nominate him, even though he is the HOH of his side of the house. I just feel like that's how the HOH can go home from week to week.
Yeah.
But it not necessarily, you don't, like, because why would you want to be HOH if then you have to automatically switch with the person if they come off the block?
Right. I mean, do you find any benefit in being HOH at all at this point?
You know, it's interesting. You know, it's a tough spot to be in because the idea of being the HOH is that you have power, but you also have safety. But now you have power, but you're also vulnerable. So you could immediately, like, somebody's like, hey, you nominated my friends, well, you're going on the block this week. So I wonder if the nominations will sort of be done simultaneously, where it's like, where like both the HOHs sort of like lock their keys in the box, and then we have sort of like a reveal at the same time where you can't change it once you find out who's nominated. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay. So like maybe the two HOHs like say to each other, hey, like you're good this week, I'm good this week, let's not nominate each other. Okay, bro. But they might actually still go and nominate each other. So I think there could be some intrigue that happens with this.
Yeah, one thing I was thinking, though, is the person whose nominations don't stand, I bet that HOH ends up getting to play in the next HOH competition.
Yeah, no, I think that would make sense. And just something that Ethan Brooks is bringing up here in the chat room, he wants to know, do you think that the HOHs can both nominate the same person? Being a double nominee would suck. And I think for that reason, I think they're going to make it that you can either, the HOH can either only nominate people from their own team or only nominate people from the other team, because then that would prevent the people from nominating the same people. Assuming the HOHs are, it's not like a situation sort of like in Big Brother All-Stars where it had to be where, who was it, Jace and who was he co-HOH with? Was it Janelle?
Janelle, yes.
And they had to come up with the nominations together. So right. I feel like so unless it's that, I think it's that you probably have I have this group of people to select from, you have this group of people to select from, and then we end up with four nominees.
What do you think would be more interesting though, like the HOH having to nominate from the other team or from his own team?
From the other team is more interesting because that's how you get the other HOH in the mix. So it's almost like you sort of have like a tribe dynamic of, hey, it's us eight, and they nominated one of our people, we'll get them. And so, whereas a lot of times on Big Brother, sometimes you can have the two sides of the house, like, organically split into two, and that's very fun to watch. But other times on Big Brother, you have a season where there's basically, like, one big group in the house, and then a couple of people just end up getting picked on the outside, and that's probably a more boring season when you have that. So this sort of really artificially separates the two sides of the house but makes them fight with each other. So I think this could actually be a fun twist to have play out, to have there be two sides of the house that are going after each other each week.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it has a lot of promise, so I'm looking forward to seeing how it pans out.
Okay. Let's go from, this is from Andy in the, on YouTube, wants to say, Are teams for BB16 officially the two groups of house guests by entry, or are they not decided yet? Do we even know? Boy, that would be confusing if the group of eight was not the group that came into the house tonight.
Yeah, considering they're the ones that played for that HOH, so, I mean, we kind of know, right?
Yeah, I think so. I think it'll be that group of eight. What do you think about, like how they do on Survivor? What if after a couple weeks, what if we had a tribe swap? Where we kept the groups together, but we switched up the players on the group.
Yeah, that would be kind of amazing. You remember during season 14 where they had the coaches competition and there was a possibility of the trade going down, right? And there was a really interesting thing where they could have traded Willie off to Dan and got both of them out at the same time, which would have been insane. So I'm excited about any kind of tribe swap or team swap or anything of that nature.
Okay. Let's go to McGurk USC, who says, is Devin just Brendan in disguise? They both try so hard to say the perfect thing all the time. Brent, like as in nobody gets in between me and my man? That Brendan?
Who was she comparing him to?
Is Devin Brendan in disguise?
Oh, gosh, you know, that's maybe a good comparison.
Yeah, you think so?
I mean, the way he talks and acts, yeah.
Okay.
Well, I mean, are you being... Do you think so?
No, I did not get that at all. I didn't think that was Brendan in disguise. But look, that's everybody is entitled to their own opinion. Okay, this is from Dartellum, who says, does touching your butt keep ghosts away? This is a good question. Brian, what's your take? Number one, are there ghosts in the Big Brother house?
No.
Okay.
If
there were ghosts in the Big Brother house, would making your butt touch somebody else's butt keep the ghosts away? Do ghosts hate butt to butt?
Do ghosts hate butt to butt? No. Yeah, because there's no point in butt to butt.
Yeah, it frustrates them.
Weak sauce.
That's weak, and it makes them leave, and they say, "Hey, nothing good's happening here." It's like if you turned on the live feeds and you saw two people in a bed, but they were butt to butt. You say, "Oh, but what's on the other camera?" So the ghost would just walk out of the room.
So what do you do? Is that like if this is your new butt to butt showmats thing? What are you gonna do? Just rub your butt cheeks together all night long?
I don't know. I don't know.
You end up with sweaty crack in the morning.
Yeah.
Stink.
It's not ideal. Okay, Adam Burt wants to know, won't the three-person alliance just be Frankie and his friends? Once Frankie is in with his followers, won't they just vote for his closest allies? Stupid twist. Well, that's a fair point, I have to say.
I don't know. Maybe I have like this hope that maybe Zach can get in there somehow.
Yeah. So, but what if, you know, I don't know if, see, that's, here's the problem for Zach, okay, hypothetically. So if we have this season, all right, and Frankie ends up having a unusual amount of power due to the Team America twist, okay, and Zach doesn't know Frankie is a powerful individual in the house, and Zach's like, hey, I'm going after Frankie this week. Boom. Now Zach becomes a big target from the people at home watching. And Zach doesn't realize that he's alienating a player who has a sister who has 17 million Twitter followers. So isn't this probably bad news for somebody who's going to be playing a very nice game in the house, an evil game in the diary room?
It's horrible news now that you're talking about it. I was like, now I'm really worried about it. Is this just going to be given, like, the America's Team America is just going to be given to, like, whoever Frankie aligns with? Is this just going to be like, well, whoever's already in the house is just going to be, you know, that alliance, they're going to get, like, even greater benefit?
Yeah. Okay, so while that could be the case, I do feel like that Big Brother, just like with the MVP thing, after a while they said, okay, well, Alyssa's just getting it every week. And they'll mix it up. So if they think Zach is, like, don't don't sleep on Alison Grodner trying to keep the show interesting, because if, you know, if basically it turns out that Frankie's getting a ton of power, but he's targeting the people who are the interesting people in the house, they will be changing that rule around. They'll figure out some different thing to make that work out. So I don't think that they're going to let a very powerful person take out the people that are bringing us entertaining television. Because we like good TV, right?
Oh, we love good TV.
We love good TV. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. This is from Brandon M. Do you think that Team America will be more like America's Player or the Saboteur? They wouldn't really give America control over three people's vote, would they?
Well, I mean, would they do something like, well, America could suggest to their alliance mates who they think they should target or whatever?
Now,
no, I agree. I don't think that that's plausible that they would do it America's Player style thing. It could be kind of in between the Saboteur twist and that.
It sounded like, did Julie say that the Team America is going to have tasks to complete in the house, right?
Yes.
So do you think that we're going to see more stuff like a Big Brother Canada, like a Big Brother UK, where kind of like the kind of things that Eric Stein had to do, where it's like, okay, that Team America needs to make, you know, make Devin, you know, say the word guacamole in a sentence, and if he does, then they will get blah, 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 and that will help them in the game. So is it going to be sort of like going on missions in the house?
I mean, that's possible, right? But that can kind of make live feeds confusing when you don't know what someone's actual motivations are, right?
Well,
when they're trying to get someone to go out on a date with them, and then it turns out just to be a task for Marsha the Moose, for instance.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I do like the tasks on the International Big Brothers. I think those are fun. This is from Don B., who wants to know, I just don't want America to vote for the cutest or the good-looking. I don't like that. America should give the person who tries the hardest, but something is up. Yes. Okay. Where's my patriotic music? Yes. This is about America. We're not going to vote for the person who's the cutest or the best looking. We vote for the person who works the hardest or has the sister with the most Twitter followers. That's how we do it, Brian.
Or is most evil.
More than most evil. This is America. It's America. People, wake up, America. Wake up.
America.
Mike Bloom says, when will Donnie reveal that he's Kenneth Parcell from 30 Rock in Method for a new movie? Do you think, is Donnie actually the actor Kenneth from 30 Rock?
No. I just saw like a picture of him with his... I mean, pretty much shaved. I mean, he had a little bit of goatee, and he just does not look like the same guy at all.
Can you confirm that he's not Kenneth from 30 Rock?
No.
Okay. Jack McBriar, I think, is the actor's name?
I don't even know who that is. That's why I can't confirm it.
All right.
Okay, yeah, we can confirm that.
We can confirm it. He's not the actor. Okay. UConn R wants to know, how long do you think that the Girls Alliance will last before they turn on each other? I can see Pow Pow getting on some people's nerves with her being so boy crazy and hyper attitude. Sorry to hear about Caleb. Yes. Thank you very much for saying UConn. So how long do you think that the Girls Alliance will last before they turn on one another? Brian, give me an expiration date on the Girls Alliance of El Cuatro.
I kind of feel like that's up to Nicole. Like, when more girls come in, what will she do is kind of where I'm looking. So, I mean, 2 weeks, I think, with that four-person alliance, I would say 2 weeks before it gets exposed.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. It's not going to last very long. There's a reason why the Women's Alliance has not worked on Big Brother in the past. Maybe these are going to be the women to make a run of it, but I feel like if there was ever going to be a Women's Alliance that worked, it's going to form around Final 7, Final 8, a la the Exterminators, a la some of these alliances that form late in the game, and it'll be just be like, hey, the four women in the house will say, hey, why don't we all just get together and make a run? And that'll be the Women's Alliance that works on Big Brother. It's not going to be from night one. Not going to happen.
But I think every season that there's going to be these girls coming in from now on out that want to do this Girls Alliance thing until it happens.
Yeah. Okay, this is from Buddy Holly, who says, what does quattro mean? Brian, can you type into Google Translate quattro?
It's four.
Yes! Yes, number four. Four People Alliance, the appropriately named quattro.
Let's exactly.
Go. This is from Delire Tancho, who says, is there any point to making alliances with your team? Only the alliance with the opposing teams matter, so their HOH doesn't put you up. Well, Brian, now, we covered a little show called The Opposite Worlds back in January, and as much as some of us tried to forget that that was a show, on Opposite Worlds, you basically had the two sides of the house. One lived in the past, one lived in the future, but we saw that it was a very powerful thing where Jeffrey, and JR made an alliance between the two sides of the house. Could you see the people? Will the final two people in this game be the two players who end up making an alliance cross team?
I feel the way it's set up, I have suspicions there'll be several of those type alliances. And some of them will get exposed, some of them will stay secret, hopefully. I think what's key to that situation is being able to keep that alliance secret.
Yeah, I think so. I think that you'll definitely see people making alliances from both from cross side of the house's alliance, cross team alliances. I think that's going to be fun to watch also. And the people who get too wrapped up in, hey, this is our team, we're the Crazy Eights, those are the
other eights.
Yeah, well, give me another. Those are the Van Buren boys. We hate them. You know, I think that those are going to be the people that lose, and the people that make the cross-team alliances are the people that are going to do well. All right. UConn, do you think that BB will let Team America know who else is on Team America, or will the TNA members think that they're the only ones who are getting the secret tasks? Boy, it's a team, right? I think you got to know who's on your team.
I would think so. But, I mean, how are they going to bring them all into the thing at the same time? Are they going? Who knows? I mean, they may tell them they have to keep a secret from each other.
They might have to. And if it changes every week, it'll be interesting. And, like, why would Team America change from week to week? Like, if it's the three most popular players on a given week, aren't the three most popular players going to be the same every week? Like we saw with the MVP twist. Like, it wasn't like Alyssa wasn't popular all of a sudden one week.
Yeah. I mean, who knows? I mean, that really wasn't supposed to be about who was popular, though, right? But this vote is asking you a popularity question. Who would you most like to work with?
Yeah. And so, okay, we'll see how that goes.
My hope is that they do end up knowing, so that it might benefit someone like Zach, who kind of gets in as the third guy, maybe gets a couple extra alliances out of it.
Yeah, I think Zach is going to need the RHAP bump if he's going to be getting Team America.
I'm not sure who else. I mean, if there's a front runner for number two and number three, though.
You know, it's going to be very interesting to see. I think it's going to be somebody who is like a Big Jeff, or like somebody who's like somebody who's just very popular with the TV viewers of the show.
Whoever's friends with Frankie.
Well, I don't know necessarily that there are the fans of Ariana Grande and Frankie Grande, and I gotta say, I felt like it was a little bit of creative accounting on Frankie Grande's part, where he called himself, he talked about, he was a YouTuber, and he says he has 1.2 million followers, but I looked at it, some of the social media profiles. I think that was like an aggregate of that. I think he took YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and sort of combined them all together, which I felt was a little misleading.
Yeah,
a little bit.
But whatever.
Whatever. Don't give me a wooden nickel. All right. So anyway. Well, I don't know necessarily to the average Big Brother watcher. If you're, you know, if you're somebody, you know, sitting there and, you know, you got your, you know, your Big Jeff t-shirt on and you're sitting there, you know, all pumped up to watch Big Brother, are you necessarily in love with Frankie Grande? Because I don't think that's necessarily the same demo that are the people that are the Frankie Grande base of support.
Oh, so you think that he might not win this vote just straight out?
I think it's going to be interesting. Just, you know, the feline-owning viewers of America, are they necessarily the same fans of the Frankie Grande supporters?
Well, not necessarily, but I think having that, first vote happen...
It's almost like this is like an interesting political debate, because you have that base of support, which we know are going to be behind Frankie. Who are the feline-owning viewers of the Big Brother? Who are they? Like, the people that voted for Alyssa last year, okay? That fan base is still there. Who are they supporting?
I don't know. I kind of see them like an Amber.
Amber. Okay. That's going to be interesting to see. So I feel like there's almost like a clash here of the Frankie support. I think we're just assuming that the Alyssa fan base is going to be going for Frankie, but I wonder if there could be some sort of butting heads there, and I wonder if there could be one person, you know, Frankie's going to be there, but whoever the, you know, Alyssa fan base from last year, who are they going to support? And that person's going to be in Team America also. And then there's going to be a third person in the mix.
Well, who knows? I mean, maybe the people won't know who their favorites are by the time all these votes have taken place. I think Frankie's vote taking place before the show even started definitely gave him a leg up, right?
Yeah.
Because everyone else, they don't even know who any of these people are unless they're watching the videos.
Yeah. It could be, we need to, basically probably what we need to do is watch Rachel and Alyssa's social media and watch who they're endorsing. And if they end up, they could end up deciding to back Frankie, though, because for whatever reason, they decide that Frankie could be their guy. And if they do that, then watch it. Then Frankie, watch out. You know, nobody
else
has
it. They'll announce tomorrow that Frankie was the winner of that first vote. So I think that's out of the picture. I think it's whoever else other than Frankie that's going to get the support. And I think it might be one of those situations where it's an actual run for the vote, you know, and maybe split.
Let's take a few more questions here on our Big Brother premiere night coverage. Don't forget, tomorrow night, Thursday night, Brian and I will be back 10:15 p.m. Eastern. We'll be joined by Ian Terry. And then once again on Sunday night, 9:15 p.m. Eastern, to talk about Big Brother's nomination show on Sunday night. Dylan Lightning says, why do you think, who do you think has a better chance, Nicole or Donnie? I hope Nicole. I think that they're both have similar chances. Who would you pick, Nicole or Donnie?
I think I'd pick... Oh, wow, that's difficult, because they both kind of expressed interest about working together, so you kind of feel like they'll kind of go along the same distance with each other, possibly. So if I'm going to pick between Nicole and Donnie, I'm going to have to go with Nicole.
Interesting. Why?
Cuteness.
Why, Donnie's not cute, Brian?
I don't know. I just feel it's like too even. I got to pick one or the other. I think maybe she may have a little bit more to work with on the charm aspect in a flirtatious kind of way. I don't think Donnie's going to be trying to do that.
This just in, Amy in the chat room is reporting that Rachel has indeed backed Frankie because he gave her a shout out tonight. So, this might be a done deal on the Team America.
Yeah, but the first vote's already over with, okay. So we don't. What I'm saying, well, if she picks Frankie, it's not gonna matter.
Yeah, no, that's interesting though that there's three people, because it's almost like, okay, well, Frankie's a given, and there he's going to get his, but you still got two other people in the mix that are going to have that same power. So in some ways, is America's Team America, is it less powerful than the MVP?
Well, yeah. I mean, the MVP got to nominate people and everything, so definitely less powerful.
Okay. So I wonder maybe
As far as we know, there's no power for this twist at all.
Yeah. I wonder if Team America is going to be sort of like, you know, a bit of a hollow victory. I wonder how much it's going to actually impact the game. I guess we'll have to see on tomorrow night.
Well, who knows? Like you said, maybe it may just be like one of these things to bring in tasks, something that we like about some of the other international versions. Or maybe there are some actual strategic things that are going to happen with this group. Maybe they'll try to push an HOH to get so-and-so nominated, you know? Who knows?
Okay. Let's do a couple more questions. This is from John Fasunda, who says, why did Cody kiss his father for so long? Hey, it's a long summer, right?
That's an odd question. I mean, why does it matter? I mean, he loves his father. It's like Cody's father is a fan of the show. You know, he's excited about his son getting to go on Big Brother, and he's leaving for 3 months. So
yeah.
Let him give a hug and kiss without.
Yeah, let him give his son a kiss. He's not going to see him the whole summer. Come on, have a heart, John. Aubra Marie says, which alliance has a better chance of making it, El Cuatro or Donnie and Devin? Well, I think this is easy. The fewer people that are in the alliance, the better chance it has of working.
Unless Devin gets targeted right at the beginning, but I would say Double D's has got a slightly better shot.
And, you know, it will be fun to talk about the Double D's in the Big Brother house this summer. That's an alliance that RHAP was born to talk about.
Yeah, but you never thought you'd be talking about it in this way.
Yeah, we could say, hey, Brian, how were the Double D's on the live feeds today?
Well, if I'd heard all of this before, like, this season started, I thought that would be the girls' alliance, the Double D's.
Yeah, that would make more sense. Instead, they're El Cuatro. Brian, you know how I feel about Big Brother alliances or any reality TV alliance with a number in the title. Is it bad to have Crazy Eights and El Cuatro?
I'm coming around to what you're saying about this.
Because you can't pretend that somebody is in the alliance. Like, Christine can't come in and say, hey, Christine, do you want to be in El Cuatro? Because she knows she's the fifth person in El Cuatro. Whereas if the alliance, even Double D's is bad, that's two. You can't bring a third person into Double D. And you can't bring in somebody who doesn't have a D in their name to Double D.
So that's like a double disaster.
Yes, that's why Dr. Will Chilltown, that's a good name. Brigade, that's fine. But you can't have these numbers in it because then you can't pretend somebody's in it and get them to vote with you because they're not. They know they're not in the alliance. Okay.
Yeah. So for instance, if Brigade was four bros, like as soon as they dumped Matt, then it would have been all over.
Yeah, that's right. Four horsemen, bad. Okay. Let's take three more questions. Andrew D. says, and also, will they do the same endurance comp for the second group? Probably. Well, that'll be pretty boring if they do the same competition again that we just saw tonight.
I don't see why they would do the same. It makes no difference. Just give them a whole different competition.
Yeah. Do we really care what the second HOH competition is going to be like? Couldn't they just like, okay, everybody, you know, pick a card. Whoever has the ace is the new HOH on the other side of the house.
Hollow. Let's play hollow.
Yeah. You know, because honestly, I would rather just see more about the interaction of the other people rather than spend 15 minutes on an HOH competition.
Yeah, but I mean, is there a possibility that they would do the same? I don't think that there is a possibility that they would do the same competition twice.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go to Dean M., who said, Julie said that the Battle of the Block will be between the two HOHs, like the coaches' competition in BB14. Well, I feel like that sounds less fun than what we came up with.
I don't remember her saying that. I guess it's just like phased right through it, but...
Maybe she didn't say it tonight on the show. She might have said it, like, on the talk or something.
Yeah, so That would be so. Well, like the HOHs are going to fight. If that's true, the HOHs are going to fight for control of their nominations to keep their nominations intact.
Okay. All right. And then let's go ahead. Let's take one last question here tonight on our Big Brother premiere night from Colton Widener, who says, will Devin keep his word with Donnie, or will Paola keep her word with the other three girls? You know, it's the first night. It's nearly impossible to keep these things going all summer long, especially when there's eight people in the house, you don't even know who they are yet.
I feel like Devin and Donnie could keep theirs. Like you said, the less number of people, the more possible it is to keep the secret, right?
Yes. Yes. Let's do one more question here. From Jason, the troublemaker. Do you think that the first eight have an advantage already with them all the alone time that they're having before Team 2 arrives? You know, we saw this in, if you watch Big Brother UK, that was definitely a thing that they did where they had, 10 people came in the first night, 6 people came in the second night. It was a big divide in the BB UK house. How divided do you think that the house guests will be after having, assuming in real Big Brother time, they were one day apart?
I mean, I feel like they're going to be very divided.
It's
I think
huge.
There's going to be
it's a big deal.
Right, because these other people have that whole day, and the new people coming in will know that, and so they will kind of solidify with their group because they'll feel like that they have no other choice. I mean, I'm looking forward to knowing which of the players, I figure Zach will be one of them, that tries to migrate and find allies on the other side.
And again, just looking ahead to tomorrow night, we get to finally get our hands on, we don't have the list open, but we have Zach coming in, we have Caleb coming in, we have Hayden Voss coming in, Derek, right? He's the guy who says, I'm going to tell it. I can't do an impression of him yet, but he's like, everybody says I look like a college kid, but I'm a cop. Like, no, you look like a cop. People are being very nice if they're saying you look like a college kid. You look 100% like a cop. Stop it.
Yeah, and we also got Brittany coming in, which is the mom of three that we have high hopes for. Your pick, Christine.
Yes. Victoria, is that the Israeli?
Yes.
Yes. She's gonna be very polarizing. And who's the other woman that's coming in?
Jocasta,
yes. Did you see the bikini pictures of everybody from Big Brother 16?
I did not see the bikini pictures, Rob.
Jocasta rocking the bow tie.
Oh, still with the bow tie. Well, maybe that's going to be her thing, the bow tie.
It's still happening. Okay. All right. So this will be a good place to stop. Anyway, I'm so excited to have Big Brother back. I think it's going to be a really, really fun summer. Looking forward to talking with you much more this summer, Brian.
Oh, I'm always looking forward to talking to y'all, and I just can't wait to get these feeds.
All right. Well, the feeds open up, I believe, what did they say, tomorrow night after the episode?
Yes.
Okay, so they will be up on Thursday evening after the show. Well, we hope you can resist watching the feeds for one more hour and watch us after Big Brother on... Actually, the feeds, will they go up after the East Coast or the West Coast?
I think it's the East or West. I mean, I don't even know, Rob.
We'll see. We can't confirm or deny when they're going to go up. Anyway, if you want to get in on those Big Brother live feeds, you have until, I think, midday tomorrow to get the early bird discount. We are going to be doing the Big Brother Bingo here on robhasawebsite.com. We'll keep it going for as long as people are interested in getting the Big Brother live feed bingo cards. And we're going to add one more prize, Brian. I will add now a additional prize to Big Brother live feed bingo for whoever ends up either with a full card first of all their spaces or the most spaces at the end of the summer, that I will add an additional $150 prize for whoever has the most spaces at the end of the summer in addition to whoever was the first person to get bingo. There you
go. That's great.
All right.
And a bouquet of flowers.
Yes. And so I want to, it'll keep going all summer long. So in case somebody gets bingo early on, then we'll keep going. But it's going to be a hard season on the live feed bingo. If you want to still get your live feeds and get your card, you can go to robhasawebsite.com /bingo, or if you just want the live feeds and you're not interested in winning $500 on live feed bingo, well, maybe you're a crazy person, you can always go to robhasawebsite.com/live feeds if you just want to support Rob as a website and not get the bingo card. All right, Brian, make sure you're locked in. Subscribe to this YouTube channel if you want to see our live shows all summer long, robhasawebsite.com/YouTube. All right, are you pumped up? Hey, are you going to be okay for the next 24 hours?
Rob, do I not look pumped up?
Yeah, I know you're pumped up. I know you're not feeling well, so I hope you are 100% ready for tomorrow night.
I am 100% ready for tomorrow night. There is no illness that could keep me away from the excitement that is about to explode from my body that you cannot see.
Whoa. Okay. I hope you're being not literal, Brian.
About the exploding excitement from my body?
Yes.
Oh, I have those moments.
Okay. Well, anyway, we hope to see you guys tomorrow night. It's going to be a very, very fun summer. Let us know what you thought in the comments. Should we give out a hashtag for tonight, Brian?
Yeah. I don't know. I mean, I wasn't good with
it. Chat room. Give us a hashtag for tonight's show. Of course, I like to give a hashtag out at the end of the podcast. If you made it all the way to the end, we'd love to hear from you guys and tell us on Twitter if you did. All right, let's see what the chat room has. They're usually a couple seconds behind where we are in the show. Let's see.
Butt to butt.
is it butt to butt? Okay. All right. So if they don't have something in the next couple seconds, all right. Let's go with that hashtag. Is that actually? You know what? That's probably. Because some of these hashtags, you want to be safe. Because you end up with, if you click that hashtag, you find things that you don't necessarily want to see, Brian.
How about butt snuggle?
Butt snuggle? Well,
I'm sorry, man.
Again, I don't know if people want to come up with something that is that inappropriate to put on their Twitter. All right. All right. If you're comfortable with that, then you can give us a butt to butt on Twitter. If you're comfortable with it, if not, then you could just tell us in the comments that you listen. Anyway, have a good one, everybody. We'll see you Thursday night.